And welcome back to Law and Crime. We're going to take a moment to welcome a special guest we have right now, exclusively coming on Law and Crime to talk to us, Mily Trevino Sauceda. She's the executive director of an organization who basically was a catalyst and a spark of the Time's Up movement. I want to welcome Mily to Law and Crime right now.
Hi.
Mily, thanks for being here with us. Talk a little bit about how your organization came about and how everything that you did led to this letter that was written by these farm workers that basically spurred national change.
I am a farm worker. I started working since I was 8 years old in the agricultural fields. And the women that many years after that I started working with the late 80s in terms of the need to build a collective, a group of in California, in the Coachella Valley, to talk about all the different kinds of abuses our community was having. We learned from each other that we had gone through so much that we needed to make sure that we were going to support each other. And even though it was hard, we did talk about labor issues. We did talk about all sorts of environmental issues, reproductive health. But it was very, very hard for us to talk about what is the violence against women. Because we would have to talk about what we consider in our communities and in our families taboos. You don't talk about sex, you don't talk about sexuality, but in the 1990s, we were able to open the silence among farm worker women in California, and then it spread around the United States in terms of the importance of talking about how women face so many different issues and abuses and were battered and were violated in different ways, that it was very, very important for us to start breaking the myths and breaking those taboos. So we started talking about violence against women in the home, and we found so much that we needed to share and support each other, and then learn where the programs were, what the services were. And then we started understanding that women in other parts of the country needed this kind of support also. So we connected with women that were working on shelters and crisis centers and that knew farm worker women. So that's how we started helping other groups evolve, and other groups that were doing labor issues where women were involved have joined. And this is why we have 15 organizations within the National Alliance of Farm Worker Women, which is Alianza Nacional de Campesinas. And so within our whole organization of 15 different groups and organizations that have joined as members, we are representing more than 700,000 farm worker women throughout the United States.
Wow, that's such a large number, Mily. And you know, yesterday, obviously, the verdict came out for Harvey Weinstein. A big day, a big win for a lot of women who have been silenced in the past, who have not been able to tell their story. What was your reaction to that verdict when you heard it?
Oh, it was finally, we as we heard yesterday's verdict who Harvey Weinstein is a very high profile person, you know, his trial, we're thinking of how it's so important for us to keep supporting women and how important for us is to make sure that as the National Alliance, we need to continue supporting each other, not just within our own movement of farm worker women, but women from the other kind of industries that are doing low pay wages, who are hurt the most because predators know that women are so fragile in terms of and vulnerable in terms of being able to make sure that they're sustaining their family, and many of us are single mothers. So for us, it was a moment of hope that finally women are getting some justice. And there is more work to do for us. There is, our children are listening, are seeing, are understanding with this verdict that it's so important that we make sure that it's out there that sexual assault and rape are crimes. And sexual assault and rape, harassment, it doesn't matter if the person has so much prestige and money, you can complain, you need to break your silence to make sure that you're going to be heard, that there is justice out there. We do have a lot more work to do, but yes, we were happy that someone at that level had a trial and had to stand in front and hear that it was a crime what he did.
Right. And, you know, you mentioned there's still a lot of work to be done specifically with these types of trials and even how they'll be tried going forward. Do you think that this trial will now sort of set a precedent or an example of how these sex crimes are tried going forward? Because, you know, many of these incidents and many of the incidents that happened with the women who testified, they were years and years ago. But obviously they still had an impact on these jurors who sat in that room and made their deliberations.
That is so true. I mean, it's trauma is not something that stays for you just 1 or 2 years. It stays with you how many years? I still remember when I was harassed. I am so lucky I was not raped. But we have encountered women that worked in the same companies that I worked. And while I was only being harassed because, let me tell you, I was working with my siblings. And so it was kind of like hard for a predator to be able to rape me. But many of these women that we have supported along the years have been on their own, have been with no whatsoever hope of anything, thinking that, okay, well, I still need to work. I still need to provide. If I can survive it, I can be able to continue to support my family. But these predators, the only thing that they're thinking of is how can they abuse and how can they take advantage of their authority, of their privilege, and at the same time, don't care exactly what is going on with their victim. To the contrary, they see it, the victim is more vulnerable, so they keep trying to stalk them and hurt them. And I was harassed several times in different kinds of companies. When I was a teenager, and then when I was a young adult, but I didn't know. I didn't know where to go. I knew it was wrong. I knew it wasn't fair. I knew I couldn't. I was afraid. I didn't know what to do. But when I started learning that I had rights, when I started learning that many more women had been at the time in the same companies were raped, that just angered me. And I said, no, this is not fair. We need to do something about it. We need to work together and let's go forward. And this is why we also have a case with
Mily, your story is so powerful here. I'm going to have to cut you off because we have to take a break. But Mily Trevino Sauceda, thank you so much for your time with us. Your message is very powerful. We are so excited and lucky that you were able to come on our network to share your story and, of course, empower others to come forward in these extreme circumstances. Thank you again. We're going to take a quick break right now on Law and Crime. When we come back, more coverage of the Harvey Weinstein trial. Stay with us here.